Namaste Sarvebhyah. So with all the saints out here, I do not know what I should be speaking here, but just as a community leader, I have a few inputs I would just like to narrate. So this movement is about Surabhi, another name for Kamadhenu, and we know that was the reason that we got Gayatri Mantra. If we follow the story of Vishwamitra, we find out that was the reason that ultimately we get Gayatri Mantra. I'm not going to communicate the whole story, but that was the reason that such a profound thing happened, and we all cherish that. Because of cows also, we can see that we found a scripture, an Upanishad, Kat Upanishad. Because the whole story was that there was a cows, and cows were not very well fed. If you read the words of the scripture, Pidodaka, Jagdatrida, Nirendriyaha. So if they are, those are the words, that those are the cows and they are like of no use. And Nachiketa's father is giving those cows. And Ananda Namate Loka. So the son thinks that my father is not going to go to the good place. He is going to get in hell, and he is doing such a great yajna, not a correct thing, and he intervenes. And because of that incident, we get Katha Upanishad, the concept of Shreyas and Prayas. So if we understand that, and again, if you go to the Itihasa, whether it's Ramayana, and we know Bhagavan comes, and then when we read the sequence where Bhagavan is born, there it says, Vipra Dhenu Sura Sant Hite Leena Manuja Avatar. So Vipra Dhenu. So further, the God came to serve cow. So who are we? How can we help into this movement? So the whole world is talking about three issues in today's world. They are world peace, they are about ecology, sustainability, and third is about economy. So we say economy, or it's peace, or sustainability. And we have answer. So cow can give an answer to at least one of them if we discuss about it, and that can be, the answer can be, and it's given into Mata Bhumihi Putroham Prithivyah. The concept of mother and son, mother and daughter, which we get from one of the, ultimately, Atharveda, the longest hymn we have over there, where we think about milking the nature, not exploiting the nature. So the nature has whatever we want, our needs, whatever we have, we can milk it. Cow can provide whatever we are looking for, needs. But when we go about not needs but the wants, then the journey is going to be very difficult. And this whole movement is towards how our needs we can control, and wants how can we control. How we can help into this big movement. And being a community leader from Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh, so we are going to be looking into whatever our gurus they say. We are the community leader, we are going to be working on those thought process. And HSS as an organization, whatever is needed, whatever can be done, we are all here to help out into making sure that those programs, those things become success. We have taken an initiative at Krishna Balaram Temple, where our volunteers are helping out. And we are almost like 1,000 hours of service we are providing over there. And whatever comes out here, definitely we are going to be helping out. Our team will be helping out, and will come and will help out. So who all have come over here, I would say that think about it and how you all can help into this movement, because cow is something which is going to be very helpful for us to know and understand. Recently I was there in India, and about an hour, about 2 hours away from Nagpur, there is a place Devlapar. And there is a Gau Samvardhan Kendra, about 75 acre land is there, and they are doing a lot of research about cow and related to cow. After spending a day over there, I was thinking about moving to India and spending time for Gaur Sambardhan. So a lot of work is being done, people are doing. How we also can be part of this movement, that's what we should think about it and help in this movement. And thank you to ISKCON, Bhakti Krishna Swamiji, Balibardhanji, Vaisishika Prabhuji, to inviting HSS to come and speak over here. Thank you very much. Please join.